Could the Cubs be ready to work a deal with their crosstown rivals for some pitching? Garrett Crochet is on the trade block. Would the Cubs make a deal with the White Sox? And what do the White Sox want in return? We're going to get into that right here on the Cubs Baseball Channel. So let's get this thing started. Like, subscribe, thumbs up. Thank you for being here. Go Cubs. Get the show started. These are always fun. Could the Cubs and the White Sox really get a deal? Hey, everybody, Mick Gillespie, Cubs Baseball Channel. Let's get into this, man. Could the Cubs be in the mix for Garrett Crochet? Be a deal with the White Sox, and the Cubs have made, what, four deals with the Sox since that Jose Quintana trade where they gave up Dylan Cease and Eloy Jimenez. I wasn't a fan of that trade. I mean, I guess looking back, you know, Quintana kind of gave you what you expected. Cease became one of baseball's best pitchers, or I think he is anyway, one of the most dominant pitchers when he's on. So both teams, I guess, did okay. If I was the Cubs, I wouldn't have made that deal. But you know what? They felt like they needed to make a deal to go to the World Series. Would they be able to make a deal here? Well, the White Sox, according to Jon Morosi, are talking to the Cubs and the Reds, or anyway, they're listed as teams that could potentially be making a deal for Crochet. Cubs just added Matthew Boyd to the starting rotation. You know, what would Crochet bring to the table for the Cubs? Actually, as bad as that White Sox team was last year, I thought he was really good. 6-12 record on one of the worst teams to ever put on a uniform, but 32 games he started. He threw 146 innings and allowed only 123 hits with 33 walks, but the guy struck out 209 batters. He's a big, strong guy. Came back from an injury, didn't play in 2022, and then got back in 23 for 13 games. And then last year on a really bad team was one of their best players, one of their best pitchers. And I thought he was going to end up going to the Dodgers, but you know, there was like a bunch of stuff going on. I don't know. Like maybe he didn't want to get traded. I don't know, but he ended up staying with the White Sox. They didn't make a deal. And now they're trying to move him because they need a lot of pieces. Now, how would the Cubs fit into this? And why would the Cubs be a really good partner? Well, what I'm understanding and what I'm hearing on the streets is that the White Sox are looking for middle infield prospects, and the Cubs have a ton of them. As a matter of fact, shortstop or second base, 9 of the Cubs' top 30 prospects fit that bill, right? So would they trade them? And then another guy, Luis Valbuena, who's in the big leagues right now, is a guy that you could actually look at, and maybe you even add him. Luis Vasquez. Oh, I say Valbuena. You remember him. Now, Luis Vasquez, who's actually a really good defensive shortstop. Guy showed some bat in the minor leagues and is on the big league roster. You know, would he be a guy the Cubs would be willing to give up, you know, if it's not one of the prospects, right? So he's on the big league roster. Maybe you trade him to the White Sox. They're looking for middle infield help. But these are the three guys that came to mind. Now, if the White Sox are looking for some immediate help, Matt Shaw, who the Cubs probably aren't going to trade. I mean, he's one of their top prospects and is someone that I feel like is going to probably break the big league roster at some time this year. James Triantos, maybe you give him up. Seems like he's been floated around. He's a hit machine, but the problem that he has is that he doesn't walk that much and he doesn't hit for a bunch of power. Shaw does. And then Jefferson Rojas is another one of these top prospects. But like I said, there's a bunch of guys in the chain who you look at and you go, hey, man, from top to bottom, there's a lot of really good Cubs prospects that can jump in and help out. And the White Sox are openly looking for that, and they're going to trade Crochet. And if you're the Cubs, is that a move you want to make? And then if you do make that, where does he fit into the starting rotation? You know, and what does that mean for some of the young guys? Do they slot out into the bullpen, or are they expendable? You know, so it's going to be really interesting to kind of see how the Cubs and the White Sox are able to work this out. But it's always tough when you make trades with your crosstown rival just because they never seem to go away. I mean, think about it. Sammy Sosa comes over from the White Sox. He ends up being one of the great Cubs of all time, obviously before the, you know, everything that happened off the field. But you just don't see these teams making a whole lot of trades just because they're analyzed so much. But lately, they have been trading partners. Theo wasn't afraid to make deals with them, and I don't think Jed is either. The Cubs have got to upgrade the roster if they're going to contend, and adding Crochet to the roster would be something that I think would help out a lot. And you know, here's a guy in Crochet who is from Ocean Springs, Mississippi, and went to the University of Tennessee. You probably remember him. He was drafted by the Brewers in the 34th round of the 2017 draft, and made his major league debut in 2020. He's really a big, tough guy on the mound. He's a pitcher that has a ton of upside, and he's had success starting and relieving. So remember 2021, he was a pitcher that had a 2.82 ERA coming out of the bullpen for the White Sox. 3-5 record that year, and again, a ton of strikeouts. In the Sox bullpen, you know, ended up getting hurt, came back and started. And I don't know why you wouldn't start him, just because if a guy can throw, you know, 46 innings and strike out 209 batters and pitch in 32 games, you know, at the major league level, I mean, that's a really good weapon to have. And, you know, if you're going to make a deal for him, I think that durability wise, you'd probably want him to start. We saw him a few times this year when the Cubs and the Sox get together. So, you know, we'll see what happens. But, you know, 6'6", 240 pounds. And again, you know, the rumors are that it's going to be the Cubs or the Reds. And we've seen the Reds are pretty active. You know, they made the deal with the Royals to get Singer. They sent off, you know, Jonathan India, former Rookie of the Year. And, you know, and they're trying to make some moves with their pitching staff. The Cubs went out and got Boyd. You know, they you know, made a deal to get some help from the Cleveland Guardians. I mean, they're going to have to make some moves to really shore up that pitching staff. And it feels like the position player group is so set just because of the way that the contracts are, that where they could really make some difference on this roster is doing it with the pitching. So, you know, we'll find out. But I'm kind of waiting on the Cubs to do something big. You know, there's people that are speculating that maybe they're in the mix for Corbin Burnes. I don't know that they are unless they trade Cody Bellinger. And it feels like that Cody Bellinger trade, maybe to the Yankees, maybe to the Angels, maybe there's some other teams out there that are interested in him, or maybe he starts with the Cubs. But they, if they can free up that $28 million, then they can obviously use that to go out and add some depth to this team. But it doesn't feel like that the Cubs are in the market right now to spend a lot of money. And we've speculated on why that is a few times on the show. So anyway, look, that's where we are right now. I wouldn't be surprised if the Cubs and the White Sox pull this off, just because I think that the Cubs have what the White Sox want and the White Sox have something that the Cubs want. So that's where we are right now. Thanks for hanging out. Get in the comments section. Cubs Baseball Channel. We'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Go Cubs. Should be as hot stove season rolls on, should be some more stuff that's worth talking about. See you then.